Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are having a wonderful, amazing, and beautiful Monday morning. Let's get this week started off right. As always, if you are new here, hello, my name is Miranda, and every summer I post Big Brother live feed updates and content, and I also post other kinds of videos, so if you like variety, make sure you hit that subscribe button. Moving on. So, you guys, this weekend we were provided some Twitter drama, and then this morning we were given some sneak peeks of the Big Brother house. There was some weird cast posting on Dish TV, and we are going to chit chat about all of that. So, first things first, you guys know I want to get the drama out of the way because I love me some drama, and let's get started. So, over the weekend, Miss Christine from Big Brother 16. That rhymes. She posted a tweet, and her tweet said, one of the rumored Big Brother 22 cast members is actually one of the meanest humans I've ever met in real life. No, it's not Nicole F. I'll tell you guys when the cast is revealed. So you guys know us on Twitter, when we are given an inch, we take a damn mile, and we are given a little tiny bit of tea, and we really roll with it. So of course, everybody started speculating, like, who is she talking about? Who could it be? Could it be Janelle? Could it be Danny? Could it be Devon? Who could it be? And so everybody in her replies was responding with that. Well, we all noticed that certain replies mentioning someone wouldn't get the same kind of response that other replies got. And that someone was Bailey. Anytime a tweet mentioned Bailey, she either ignored it or gave some vague response that was like alluding to it being her. And then finally, at some point, she just kind of admitted, like, yes, I'm talking about Bailey. And that kind of unleashed a tsunami of
whoa.
Because Twitter fans, Bailey fans, or Big Brother fans, Bailey fans to be specific, and then, you know, Bailey's husband, Swaggy C, obviously got on the defense. Rockstar, she threw out a tweet mentioning the situation, and that's kind of how it went down. Big Brother / Bailey fans were just not very happy with her. They felt that she was targeting Bailey for no reason. Swaggy obviously wasn't happy with her because that's his wife. Hello, if you're going to mention someone, especially someone's wife, and say and accuse them of being really mean, then that's not cool. And then Rockstar, she defended her friend. Well, I don't know if they're friends anymore. I heard through the grapevine that they aren't friends anymore, but they were at one point, so she's going to defend her. So Swaggy C, his tweet said, y'all saw what happened the last time I exposed a reality star. Just a PSA, don't try me. So that was basically a Christine, you better watch it. And then Angela, she tweeted out, okay, well, now I stepped in it just reflecting on edits. Let me be clear, Bailey Dayton is a nice girl. She's nowhere near the meanest person ever. I had no idea that was said. It's simply untrue. Whether she and I talk often or talk never again, I'm not letting that fly. Well, Christine decided to no longer be telling that story, which really sucks because I'm nosy and I got curious and I'm like, dang, I really wanted to know what the story was. Yeah, I really wanted to know what the story was, so I'm a little sad by that, but it's whatever. Like, somehow Evil Dick got involved. I have no idea. All I saw involving Evil Dick was someone mentioned, I think it was Christine, mentioned HIV and being karma, and that's fucked up. So if that's true, then I'm not about that life. I really don't like that. However, Christine is really coming back on a Twitter with a vengeance, and I'm here for it. So I'm going to be following her and seeing what other tea she spills, because she seems to be in a mood, and I'm really here for it. Okay, moving on to the more important shit, because although I love the drama, I can't wait to talk about this house theme. I am here for it. I love, so far from what we've seen, the house direction and decoration and things like that. So I'm going to insert some pictures. And yeah, let's just get started talking about it. The only rooms that we really saw were the kitchen and the bedrooms. I'm also going to insert a little video clip of a house tour right here.
Here's your first look at the new kitchen in the BB All-Star Loft.
This year's Kitchen pays homage to some of the biggest all-star moments from the past two decades of Big Brother. This splatter paint street mural, which surrounds the kitchen, features moments like Dr. Will acting as the puppet master, Derek working undercover, Rachel and her call to floaters to grab a life vest, Danielle's diary room devil horns, and of course, Dan's funeral. Continuing the loft look, the kitchen contains more graffiti artwork and vintage shelves over the painted brick walls. Spray paint can sculptures populate the hallway walls provided by an artist in Croatia, and a new lighted ceiling piece ties the entire look together. And that's our tour. I'm Julie Chan Moonves from somewhere near the Big Brother house. I'll see you soon.
So that was the video of the house tour, and as you heard Julie say, the theme is like in the kitchen, like a loft style, which I loved. I love like the spray paint look. The spray can like kind of looks stupid. It looks a little wonky, but whatever, I'll accept it. However, I really love that, you know, we have greats like Dan and Derek up in there. Casey is somewhere in there, which to me, she's not a great. Like, I don't know. I guess maybe because she just won. I don't know. That'd be like putting Josh up there to me. Like, I just don't understand them. I don't know. I'm just not a fan, okay? But I guess the good thing about her being up there means that she is not going to be on the cast, so that's great. So, I really love the theme of the kitchen. And then we have the bedrooms, which I think are so cute. We have this one room where there's like keys involved, like the HOH. It kind of looks like it looks to me like an old school HOH room. That's what it looks like to me. But the keys are obviously, you know, like a throwback to the key wheel, which is great. And then we have a room that looks like the comics, you know, the Big Brother comics, which is awesome. Love that. And then the third room is kind of looks like they're doing a really more simple, classy looking DR style room where there's like a filming light and ring lights and stuff like that. I really loved it. I thought it looked so cute, and I can't wait to see the rest of the house. The rooms that we haven't seen were the kitchen or the bathroom, the HOH room, the little loft area, hangout area, normally where the chess board is, and then that side room that people hang out in that, you know, way back in the day was the gym, but then they turned it into like a lounge room. And you guys, I'm such a dummy. They did release the living room and chess area. I had it saved on my phone and everything, and it just slipped my mind. For some reason, I totally forgot about the living room and the chess area. I thought that they didn't upload it when I saved it to my damn phone. Like, oh my god. It's one of those days already, and it's only 11:30, so bear with me. I am loving the living room area. It gives me 1970s vibes, and I'm here for it. I love the whole house theme. The decoration is so cool to me, and I'll probably hate it by the end of the year or end of the season because I'll be looking at it all summer, but I'm here for it right now, and I'm really enjoying it. There's like these lights in the living room that kind of remind me of, I don't know if you guys remember those candies that were like on paper, and there were like dots everywhere, and there were like rainbow dots, and you had to like peel them off the paper to eat them. That's kind of what those lights remind me of. Let me know in the comment section if you remember them and if you get the same vibe. See ya. Obviously, we haven't seen the backyard yet. So those are the rooms that we haven't seen, but so far, so good to me. Now, the last bit of news that we are going to talk about is this. There was an official leak, but Dish TV did post a list of cast members on their description for Big Brother. And the cast members that they listed are Janelle, Kacer, Casey, Tyler, Bailey, Nicole, and Devon. So those are the cast members that they leaked onto their little description of Big Brother 22. And I mean, we basically, like, I So I'm really excited for the cast members to be officially announced, but at the same time, it's like we already kind of know who the cast is going to be. We've been talking about this for at least 2 weeks. And so are we really going to be that surprised? No, but it's still going to be exciting. So seeing this is kind of more confirmation that we are on the right track. I am a little surprised to see Casey on there. So I'm wondering if maybe she will be in the house. I do know that people are speculating that if you are on the kitchen wall, then that means that you're not going to be in the house, because, you know, Dan is on there, Derek's on there, a quote from Dr. Will is on there, things like that. So people who aren't in the house so far are not on the wall. So it'd be really weird for them to put Casey on there. And you know, the fact that I just think that she was a boring winner, but whatever. So to see her name on that Dish TV list is a little surprising to me, but weirder things have happened. It is definitely on brand for 2020, so I wouldn't be shocked if she's in the house. I'll just be a little like, oh dang it. Now, we could also be voting people in, so that could be a possibility. I know for Big Brother 7, which was the first All-Star season, we voted some people in, and that was exciting. So who knows? We won't know officially until Wednesday, and I'm real excited. So on Wednesday, I was gonna try to go live, but then I realized that the premiere is right around Amelia's bedtime. So what I think might end up happening, I don't know if this is confirmed yet. I know Jolene and I were talking about it. We might do a pregame live on her channel. So that might be the only time I'll go live for premiere night. What I will do is go live the next day on Thursday, and we can talk about things. I will try to go live on my channel during the initial like cast reveal, but I won't be able to go live during the entire episode, and I won't be able to go live after because Amelia needs to go to sleep. So there's that. So I will go live for a little bit during the initial cast reveal, like I said, and then definitely on Thursday to talk about the episode and how we feel about things. Let me know in the comment section what you guys think, and I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. I will see you guys in my next one. Love you, bye.